Hello everyone and welcome to episode 4 of the Green Scrapper Machine. Today I'm going to show you how to make this gatefold card. And this card does not require the use of a Cricut, just a lot of measuring skills. I have been working on different variations of this card all morning. So let's go ahead and get started. The base of your card will measure at 4 1/4 by 11. Then your two side panels measure at 1 3/4 by 4. The inside of your card measures at 3 1/4 by 4. And then your top squares measure at 3 1/2 by 3, 2 3/4 by 3, and 2 1/2 by 2 3/4. So I guess they're not technically squares, they would be rectangles. But those are what go on the top of your card. And then I'm using a piece of ribbon by Paper Tray Ink in the Pure Poppy color. And I'm also using this flower from the Dollar Spot at Michael's. I'll get a little more detailed about the flower in a little while. The reason that I'm using the flower is because I'm submitting this card into Momo's challenge, her Tuesday challenge. She has the challenge this week of creating a project using a flower. So let's go ahead and start by scoring the base of our card. And the first score you're going to make is at 2 inches. The next score will be at 3 3/4. And then 7 1/4. And your last score line will be at 9 inches. And then your inner two score lines you're going to fold in. And then your outer, you're going to fold out towards you. And you've created your gate. The side panel, I chose white, and I ran it through my Texture Boutique using the Cuddlebug folder of Seeing Spots. And what I'm going to do, and this is the other variation that I decided upon, is use some of my red ink, and I'm just going to dab it along the outer edge of my white pieces of cardstock. It'll bring a little bit of that red color into the white. Along all four edges like that. And while I have this ink out, I'm just going to go ahead and do all of my white pieces of cardstock. So this is my inner piece that will go the inside of my card. And my top layers for the outside of my card. This is a great way just to add a little bit of dimension and color to the layers of your card. Alright. I'm going to go ahead and put my panels on the outside of my card. Close up my card here. Zoom in a little so you can see what I'm doing. And then take my panel for one side, and I'm just going to put a little bit of an edge along the inner fold of my card on both sides. So both sides, all sides of the white now have a little bit of a border of the red. Then I'll go ahead and work on the inner layer of my card. And I adhere that down. Sorry, I'm not in camera shot. There we go. Just put it in the middle. And then I have these cute little flowers from a different stamp set. And I'm just going to stamp those on the bottom of this layer. And there you go. Still have plenty of room to write. Then I'm going to go ahead and finish up the top layer. I'm going to start with my largest square first, and I'm just going to wrap a little bit of my ribbon along the middle of that. And because you're going to see a little over half of this piece when you open your card, I'm just going to bring the ribbon as far over to the left side as possible so that you don't see the tape. Go. Just make sure that that's in the middle. And then I'm going to adhere my red piece. Now I'm going the long way. You can also make it. I'm going this way with my card. You can also make it going that way, it doesn't matter. Adhere my final layer down. There we go. And then we're going to get the flower attached. And these flowers from Michaels come very flat. And so what I've done is just wrinkled it and then unfolded it, and that will add even more dimension to your card. So we'll go ahead and start with the largest layer. I'm going to use my basic mono adhesive and glue down each layer. And then they also come with little gems to place in the center of the flower. And I'm just going to adhere that with a mini glue dot. Put it right down on my glue dot and lift it up. And then place it in the center of the flower. And there is the completed flower, all four layers. And to adhere it to my card then, I'm going to put adhesive onto the left side only of this cardstock. Close up the card so that I get it in the center. And then I'm going to use a 3D glue dot. And they're quite large and they have a slight dimension to them. I'm going to put that in the bottom of my flower. Lift that up. And put it in the middle of my square. And there you go. Now I'm just going to add my little sentiment. And my sentiment says, just a note. Using my Perfect Match Black from Paper Tray Ink. Get that nice and inked up. Then close my card again, because what I want is for just A to be on my left and note to be on the right. And there you go. There's your completed card. Thanks for watching another episode of The Green Scrapping Machine. Have a great day.